Hi, welcome back. So we're going to look at now a slightly more difficult problem of tracking a moving goal. Why would this be important? Let's say that the goal that you want to track here, the mouse, is actually moving from side to side, and really you want to be able to track its movements to be able to catch it. Okay, so how would you, in this case, optimally design this action? Our setup is the same. So how would you design this action to track this moving goal? G. Now G basically becomes a function of T. In fact, the setup stays very similar. So here, remember this was our LQR problem, and this was the cost function that we wanted to minimize. This remains very similar. Here we wanted to get to the goal and limit the control effort and find A of T such that this cost function is minimized. So you'll notice now in this case, while we're trying to track a moving object, G has now just become G of T. So I'll flip through these slides again so you'll notice the difference. G here is static, and here we have G of T as a function of time. There's also this extra addition, and that is the A bar of T. It's actually the target action given the goal, and there's a bit more information about this in the exercises. But basically, now our A of T becomes a function of this S of T as well as the time-varying goal. And the rest is history. The rest is pretty straightforward. So I basically want to, in this next exercise, to design this time-varying goal, in this case a sinusoid, but feel free to play around with other time-varying goals, and really visualize the optimal control solution for tracking this goal, and play around with the row again to see exactly what effect that has. Great, have fun with this.